In this video, we will see how to monitor the scaled analog data and the digital output status of the last video. Building on the connection of the previous video, the I2C LCD is connected to the Arduino Nano PLC I2C port, with the SDA of the LCD connected to the PLC SDA pin sockets. SCL to SCL, VCC to VCC, and GND to GND. For an Arduino Nano board, the LCD SDA is connected to pin A4 of the Arduino Nano, the SCL to pin A5, the VCC to 5 volts, and the GND to GND. The Outseal Studio does not currently have any instructions that support character display on LCDs. The PLC instruction data and status can be observed and monitored when the studio is in online mode. Let us adjust the high and low limits of the limit block from the previous video program to 80 and 30 respectively. Ensure that the PLC baud rate setting is 57600 or 115200 before entering the online mode. As the potentiometer is adjusted, a live 8.1 value can be seen on the instruction and the simulation window. Arrow.1 lights up on the instruction and the simulation window when the I.1 value is between 30 and 80. In the same vein, the serial monitor in the Arduino IDE can be used to view data status in the Arduino Nano PLC. The baud rate for communication with the Arduino Nano PLC should first be set to 9600 in the setup function. The values of the analog data, I1, and output status, R1, will be printed on the serial monitor with the serial print object. 100 millisecond delay will ensure that the data can be observed on the serial monitor. Upload the sketch into the Arduino Nano PLC and open the serial monitor. The live analog data of I1 and the output status of R1 from the PLC can be seen on the serial monitor. The Arduino Nano PLC data and status can also be monitored with an I2C LCD. To get the I2C LCD working, you must first install the Liquid Crystal I2C library. The library should be included at the top of the sketch, along with wire.h for I2C communication. For my LCD type, I will set the address to hexadecimal 27 and the size of 16x2. The LCD should then be initialized in the setup function and the backlight turned on. We will set the LCD cursor here to display analog at column 0, row 0. The text lamp is in column 0, row 1. In the loop function, the scaled analog value is set to be displayed at column 8, row 0, in front of the analog text. For the lamp on-off status, the text on is displayed in column 6, row 1 in the if statement. While the text off is displayed on the same column 6, row 1 in the else statement. Upload the code into the Arduino Nano PLC. Observe that the analog scaled value of the potentiometer is displayed on the first row of the LCD, and the lamp off status is displayed on the second row. The displayed analog value increases as the potentiometer is adjusted. When it is greater than 30, on is displayed as the lamp status, and changes back to off when it is greater than 80. That is it for now. In the next video, we will consider the timer functions of the PLC. Thanks for watching. Please hit the like button and the subscribe button if this video is helpful to you. And see you in the next.